coordinator of the function, Mr. Kohli, who has assisted us in organizing this program. My colleagues in Hyderabad City Police, Chauhan, additional CP Law and Order, Vish Prasad, DCP Central, and Avinash Mohanty, and other staff and officers of Hyderabad City Police, and all the children who have come for this cyber internship program. A warm welcome to all of you on behalf of the Hyderabad City Police. For all the students who have come today, is this your first visit to any police office?
Yes.
जब 100 बच्चे हो तो yes बड़ा ये धीमा धीमा है ज़्यादा और जोश होना.
Yes.
Okay, so how does it feel to be in a police office? Is it little scary or is it a happy situation? Or before you came, did you feel that you are going to a police institute? Thoda dar tha, aake shanti hui hai. How do you feel about it? Excited. Okay. Somebody said thoda dar bhi hai. Koi bola na? Okay. So I'm sure pehle zarur dar raha hoga. Once you've come to your office, you would realize that it's a very people friendly, children friendly, all friendly kind of office. And we will also, I will request Mr. Rakshit Tandon to at least put a 1 hour period slot for them, in which we would like to show them around the CP office, which includes our command and control center. And since they are all our budding technical people for future, we'll show how technology is being now these days leveraged by the police for all the different purposes of prevention of crime, for detection of crime, for maintaining law and order, for managing traffic. So a visit to our command and control centers, our traffic control centers, all of which are located in this office, we'll schedule a session for you, so you know what and how what we are doing here. Now coming back, you know, to all of you who belong to 5 different institutes of Hyderabad, sir, in the last week for 2 days, we had an awareness program in 5 different colleges of Hyderabad, which were Vasavi, Nizam College, Narayanamma Engineering Institute, CMR Engineering Institute, and St. Anne's Engineering Institute. And during this St. Anne's Engineering College, okay. So, in these, in 2 days, 5,000 students were covered, and an awareness was created about cyber security. And all these institutes were asked to nominate 20 best children from their school, college, who would be put through this internship program which has been designed. Now, in this internship program, what we plan to do is, you know, teach them various tools for security, including website security, about online frauds, about email crimes, about mobile security, and other aspects of cyber crimes. The children will go through these 6 days of intensive morning to evening session, which will be taken up by Mr. Rakshit Tandon and our experts from the field of our cyber crime. They will also be visiting our cyber lab and cyber police stations beside, as I said, the CP office. The aim of the program is, one, that these children will be our ambassadors for creating cyber awareness in their respective colleges and also in other institutions. And secondly, they will be given an opportunity to develop tools so as to which can help in prevention of cyber crimes or frauds, or assisting the younger generation in you know, being safe while they are on the cyber world. So with these two aims, we have started this program. Now we want to use the power and the knowledge of youth in you know, in fighting the cyber crime. We all know that this generation, the millennials, are the ones who can change you know, who can change the world. Just recently, how many of you have heard of Greta Thunberg? Is there anybody who's not heard of it? Or anybody has heard of Greta Thunberg? The teenager who has rattled the world community and the world leaders by her speech, "How dare you," at the UN General Assembly? Yes, sirf 4-5 yes lag rahe hain, sun rahe hain.
Yes.
She is all over the social media. Yes, you've heard. So just see how a 16-year-old can, you know, create a sensation. It rattled even the president of the USA. If you have seen the kind of expressions which were exchanged, and it were all over there. That is the power of youth. That is the power of communication. And that is also the power of the social media. 20 years back, if somebody had made a speech at the UN General Assembly, speeches have been made since the UN has been created. But it did not spread, or it did not become viral the way now this platform of internet and social media, which is available with us, that everybody around the world knows about it. So this is the power of the internet and social media. I know that your generation, you live in this virtual world in a way. Whether it is networking, whether it is making friends, whether it is studying, whether it is gaining knowledge, whether it is shopping, whether anything, all aspects of our life are now centered around the internet. So all of you are very aware that this internet is an extremely good tool for knowledge, for development, for everything. But as in any media, there is also need for precautions to be taken. Now, internet is also the area where most of the crime has shifted. So, because when we operate on the internet, when you're doing net banking, or when you're shopping, or whether it is matrimony, when we move to internet, the criminal also moves to the internet. So therefore, the needs for do's and don'ts and precautions is very important. Now, with you who are already aware of this, you know, you are all budding engineers, and we would want you now to take a lead in developing these tools which can help other children from protecting. You see, most of the offenses on the social media affect children, or, you know, the maximum age would be somewhere up till about 30-35 years. And also, the number of criminals or our offenders in the cyber world are also young people. So it can be used anyway. For example, I was told that there was an IIT Kharagpur graduate who was arrested by the Bangalore police for hacking the Aadhaar data. Okay. Similarly, if we don't talk about cyber, the power of the youth, you have the OYO, the startups, started by Ritesh Agarwal when he was just about 17 years old. His net worth is about more than 36 million now. Flipkart again started with youngsters. So the potential is great for all of you. All you need is that to move in the right direction, and this field of cyber or the internet, this opportunity which has provided you, we have to use them for the benefit of the society. We have to use it not only for individual, your own development, and for the development of the society. So all of you now, 100 of you, we hope that in these 6 days, you will benefit from what we tell. Out of you, we will also be selecting the best people who are developing certain tools which can help in awareness or cybercrime prevention. And these children, we will be even further nurturing, for guiding them and nurturing them. So I hope that all of you do benefit from this 6 days which you are going to be put here. Mr. Rakshit Tandon has a very packed program for you, and I don't think you are going to get any relief in these 6 days. It's going to be real hard work, but I'm sure that at the end of these 6 days, you will feel that yes, you've learned. And then when we talk on the final day, I'm sure that we will have a bright sparks and some new tools developed which will assist us in fighting crime in Hyderabad City Police. All the best to all of you, and I hope it will be a nice experience for you.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you for inspiring the students and also putting the things in perspective.